I got an interesting phone call the other day. I usually start videos like this because that's part of the fun of being an extension educator. But what they sent me, and this was around early April, mid-March, was a orange gelatinous ball. This one was very large, was about the size of a baseball. And it had like, looked like fingerlings. It looked like something out of an alien horror movie. And what it was cedar apple rust. Now, what people call this gall here is a cedar apple. And we can actually see some remnants, and I'll pull it closer to the camera here in a little bit, but we can see some remnants of the orange tentacles, or what they actually call them, tendrils. And I'll put that word up there for you. But what those are, they're putting off spores of the cedar apple rust fungus. And it actually has a very interesting life cycle. It's a two-plant fungus. It actually has two hosts. It has the cedar tree, or many evergreen trees, and primarily apple trees, but it will also go on to pear trees, fruit trees, and other ornamental type trees like Bradford pears, along those lines. So we actually have a calorie pear, an invasive Bradford pear here, and we have cedar apple rust on it. Now, the other host is literally right there, so I would say pretty confidently that this is cedar apple rust. And I don't know if you guys can see the pattern on it very well. Let me see if I can find another one. Here's an even better one. We actually can see it's on the stem of this one, but this pattern right here, see how it kind of follows just a couple, maybe a centimeter, like a quarter of an inch away from the main middle vein on this plant. And then we can also see the darker circle around the plant. If we flip it over, there are a few of them that are producing little hairs under the leaf. And those are the tendrils on the apple or the fruit plant that you will see. So just a little help to identify it in the Bradford pear or the apple tree. This is largely what it looks like. And really after this stage, there's really not a lot we can do about this. So after identifying what the problem is, the usual follow-up question we get is, how do I kill it or how do I get rid of it? And the answer usually is, well, if we're seeing it on our apple trees, it's probably too late already. There still is a chance that you have a decent apple production, but anytime a tree is weakened, it certainly can affect the production of that tree. So, what do we recommend? Well, it's more preventative than reactionary in this instance. We recommend spraying anywhere between the green tip phase to 2 weeks after petal fall, a copper-based fungicide. And we have three that we recommend for cedar apple rust. That'd be Nova 40W, Rubigan EC, and Xyram 76DF. These are all fungicides that you could probably find at your home and garden store, or maybe over at your nursery, or maybe even possibly at your co-op. You can find them at a lot of places. Be sure to check the label instructions. The main reason you would want to read those label instructions is because there is a harvest holdout period for a lot of these fungicides, because they are a certain level poisonous to people who might consume them. So, Nova and Xyram both have 14-day holdout periods. So likely if we're spraying between that recommended window of green tip to 2 weeks after petal fall, we'll probably be okay anytime we're going to have a harvestable fruit. But with Rubigan, we actually have a 30-day harvest holdout period. So from when you spray to when you harvest, you need to wait 30 days to be completely safe consuming that product. So be sure to follow those dates, write down that date when you do spray, and make sure that you're not consuming that product inside that holdout period. If you'd like more information on cedar apple rust, please look up the OSU fact sheet, EPP7611, on osufacts.okstate.edu. And as always, you can contact your local county extension office for help identifying or for treatment options of cedar apple rust and many other diseases and problems that may be in your landscape. Thank you. Follow K County OSU Extension on social media to keep up to date on upcoming events, educational information, and research-based information. Thank you for watching.